Today, I wanted to show you some practical use cases for GPT-3 or other similar large language models. I personally use these prompt techniques, I would almost say every day. Anyway, let's just get going and have a look at the first tip. So the first tip I wanted to show you is how you can complete lists or steps by using a function called insert from OpenAI's GPT-3. Let's say you are wanting to write an article or something about how to create wealth, and you want some topical outlines for this. And what you want to do is, let's write the following are topic outlines for how to create wealth. And we write point one. But if you go over to here, you can see there's something called insert. Just click on that. And if we fill out like this, with this, so we write the first point we want is introduction. Then we go curly brackets, insert curly bracket. And the last outline we want is our conclusion. So what the GPT-3 engine is going to do with this insert function is fill in everything in between. So if we hit submit here now, we can see that the following topic outlines how to create wealth is one introduction. And then it fills out these four extra ones. What is wealth, how to build wealth, how to protect wealth, case studies on building and protecting wealth. So I think this is a very efficient way to create outlines for you. If you need to write an article or if that's not a school assignment or something. Let's have a look at another example of the insert function. Okay, so let's say you wanted to find out different types of renders you want to use for your AI art creation. So the following are adjectives to describe different types of renders. So we know what the first render is, but we want to use the insert function here to get like a list of it. So let's just paste the first one we know is Octane Render. We know that one. And we know one other render called Blender, but we need more. So what we go here is 1.OctaneRender. And the last one we know is Blender. So here we want the GPT-3 engine to give us 6 more. We just write curly bracket, insert curly bracket, and hit submit. And now we can see that the results are 6 other types of renders we can use for our AI art. Okay, so the second tip I have for you is how you can summarize a text from like an article or something you read and turn it into a professional email that you can distribute to your colleagues or your friends. So let's say you read this article that you really liked, but it was quite long, but you really wanted to share it. So what you can do is just copy all of the text and just paste it into the playground. You might want to leave a link in the email to give some credit to the author, but for this example, let's just say you write this prompt, write a concise summary of the following text. So just start with that, jump it down to 0.7 and hit submit. And here you can see the AI is just summarizing this text into a couple of lines, sentences. And the next thing you want to do is just write this, I have this ready here. You want to just follow up with this prompt. Write a professional email from the summary and sign from All About AI. Hit submit. Here you can see it turns it into a very easy to read email. You can always just add your friend's name, hello Grant, best regards, All About AI. So instead of sending the whole link so your friends have to read the whole thing, you can just summarize it for them. And maybe leave the link in, I guess you could just leave the link like this. There you have a ready to go email in, I would say this would take you like 2 minutes. The third tip I have for you is just using GPT-3 as a search engine. Let's just say you're wondering about when did World War II end? So this is at 1945. You can just follow up a date. So the nice thing is you can always ask follow-up questions. You can go, how did it end? The allies. Who are the allies? Who are the allies? Okay. China. So, you get the point. It's very easy to just, let's say you wanted to go to Google, you will get the answer, but there's a lot of work to follow up if you wanted to know more. So this is quite easy way to do it because it basically knows all the answers, at least from history. There's just one thing, if you go very deep into this, you always want to go and fact check this because it can make things up. The next tip I have for you is how we can use GPT-3 to insert and add more relative text to an already, let's say, existing email we want to send. So we have this email, it's ready to be sent, but we feel like there is something missing. So what you can do is go over to, yet again, go to the insert function. And we're quite happy with the email, but we feel like we need to explain, let's say, reinforcement learning. So what you can do is just go behind the word and go curly brackets, insert, curly bracket, I guess we can add, and just hit submit. So what the engine is going to do here is add more relevant text. So you can see it added, the company is currently building a new class of AI system that is more interoperable, reliable, and controllable. And I kind of feel I need some more here. Then you can just copy this again, paste it here. I want to write a bit more about large language models. So just go curly bracket, insert here, submit. Now we can see it just added GPT-3, but okay, you get the point. So it's a very nice way to add more relevant text to an already almost ready document. So I use this all the time because want to fill out or explain something a bit more in depth. The last tip I have for you today is one I use all the time. So let's say I found this very interesting article, but I don't really have time to read the whole thing. So what I do is just copy the old text, paste it into the playground. And my go-to prompt here is write a list of the most important key takeaways from the text below. So I always try to keep the temperature a bit low, so let's say 0.5, and the length is, that's okay. Hit submit. And from my experience, this always gives me a very good and easy way to get the gist of the article. So it's almost, I would say 90% time. If I just read these takeaways, I get like the most important things from this. So if you do a lot of reading or something at work or at school, or you handle a lot of text that you have to read through, I would really recommend you try this. Write a list of the most important key takeaways from the text below. You can also do like a summary, but I found that you get a bit more detail if you do key takeaways. Anyway, that is the last tip I have to. Okay, so I hope some of these tips could inspire you to start exploring large language models like GPT-3. And if you like this video, I think you should check out this one, where I have more tips for GPT-3 for beginners. So anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.